Hey, what's up, everybody? My name is Larry, aka LCD, and today we're going to be playing some Hearthstone. So if you guys have been made aware, I'm sure by now, that the new Hearthstone expansion, the Grand Tournament, is now out as of a couple of days ago. And I haven't really had too much chance to play the new expansion. I mean, I've been really busy. I did a 24-hour live stream, so you know that took the wind out of me. I actually completed 100%. I completed it successfully, and it was really fun. But today I want to show you guys a new Druid deck that I made, and it's actually been working pretty well so far. I mean, obviously I had a couple of losses, but it's the expansion's new. People are still figuring out decks, what's good, what's not. And I am running a new, control Druid, I guess. A control Druid. And there's a lot of stationary cards that you know and love from Druid, but there's also a couple of new ones in there from the expansion. I'll go ahead and have the deck list for you on the side of the screen when I edit this video. But this deck revolves around playing really big minions, getting the lead with Innervates, Wild Growths, and there's also a new Druid card in this game. It's a 2-mana drop that allows you to get a free mana crystal when you play her, but you actually lose that mana crystal when she dies. So it's really good for the early game, not so great in the late game. So it's really good that you draw her. As you can see, we got a brand new card already in Aviana. All my minions cost one less. So if you play her in conjunction with Innervate and stuff like that, or a coin, then you can, you know, play an Ancient of War that turn, or Emperor Thurisane for one mana each. And if you combine that with Innervate, then you can just play multiple minions at once, and it just gets really crazy. So we're just going to go ahead and mill those. Okay, Wild Growth is good, Wrath is good, Kel'Thuzad, not good. So this deck runs a bunch of legendaries. We run Kel'Thuzad, we run Ragnaros, we run Aviana, as you guys just saw, we run Thurisane, we run Dr. Boom. Lots of legendaries in this deck. And why? Well, because most of these legendaries that we're playing are really good, and they can be played relatively quickly because of the fact that we are getting so much mana very early in the game. So Wild Growth, that new two mana drop. It's a 2/3 for 2 mana that gives you a mana crystal. The card is ridiculous. We didn't draw it here, but I assure you it is ridiculous. So we got a Wrath. We got to Wrath that. He's obviously going to plan to play that one card. Muster for Battle! I hate that card, man. It's so annoying if you don't have Swipe against Druid. Is he still going to opt to play Muster for Battle? Nope. Alright, that must die as well. So new GVG card, summon. Just makes your hero power really good. And I'm gonna innervate the Sludge Belcher. We could have saved that innervate for turn 4 Rag, but I'd rather get the Sludge Belcher out there now. Because at the end of the day, the Zombie Chow is gonna give us 5 health no matter what. So the entire point of this deck is to basically just control the board until you just overwhelm your opponent with this giant minions they can't deal with. We also run Faceless Manipulators in this deck, and those are really good for the sole reason that we run a bunch of legendaries. So if we get the opportunity to do Faceless Manipulator, a Kel'Thuzad, or a Rag, or they just don't have the answers for all of our legendaries, we basically just get free legendaries for 5 mana. It's really good. So he has the True Silver here. I'm pretty sure he did not want to do this, but he had no choice. We go up 3 life. He still has to deal with the 1-2 taunt afterwards, which he can't deal with till next turn. We can innervate into Rag here. So this is really good, because now we force him to consecrate, or equality. But if he equalities now, it just means that he doesn't have a way to deal with my Kel'Thuzad or my Aviana or anything. Unless he has both equalities in his hand already, which is very unlikely, but I'm sure he has an equality somewhere. Now, we don't have very many cards, which is really bad. But the bright side to all this is that we do run Nourish. Nourish is very good in this deck. Ooh, Faceless Manipulator, boys. Well met. really awful, that rag. Both rags hit the boom bots. That's really terrible. Now, if he has the combo to clear this boar, that's going to be devastating for us. Absolutely devastating.
I have no time for games.
That's also equally as devastating. Now, I guess we play Boombot, Dr. Boom, and just hope for the best. No! I mean, that's probably good as well. I mean, ideally we wanted him to take a Boombot, but having him take Dr. Boom is still good because it can't clear the rag on its own, and rag doesn't trade with itself, so that's really good.
I've got the beast in my sight.
Top deck big game hunter. Oh, that's a crate. He top decked big game hunter. Unbelievable. Wow, we got the worst boom bots in the history of the game.
My winged children fill the skies.
Oh shoot, I forgot. That was a misplay by me. That was definitely a misplay by me. We really wanted to play Kel'Thuzad with that. So that was really dumb. Silence, boys. It's fine. It's actually really fine. Because now we get to play this for free. Oh my god, that misplay could have cost us the game. It might still cost us the game, because I don't know if he runs heals or not. I don't know what kind of deck he's playing. I mean, if he's running... Every deck in the game still runs Dr. Boom, by the way. The card is just too good. It'll never get nerfed either. That's a good boom bot for us. Okay. Hit face! Yes! I have the worst luck with boom bots. As you guys can see this, Jer, he got 7 damage off his boom bots. I got 2. My luck is awful.
Reporting for duty.
That's terrible.
Arms, men.
All right, looks like we win this game. I don't know what kind of paladin he was playing, but it's obviously terrible. Do we have lethal? Let's see if we give her 7 plus 11.
Oh. These talons.
Woo! GG's, boys. So, that was a really weird game. It wasn't really good enough to show you the power of this deck, but it's a very good deck. Like I said, I hope you guys enjoyed the deck list. Hope you guys enjoyed this game. I really enjoy Druid. I think it's one of the more fun class to play in the game. I'm trying to get it 500 wins, as you can see here. I have 500 wins with Paladin. I have 500 wins with Hunter. I have 500 wins with... guess that's it. Just Hunter and Paladin. So, we're working on Druid next. thank you all so much for watching the video. I hope you enjoyed it. I encourage you to, just experiment. This is not a net deck. I did not take this off the internet. This is something I created on my own. And it's a very good deck. I think it shows some potential. There's probably a few tweaks that you can make in here. For example, I have Healing Touch. You could go with or without this card, just depending on how familiar you are with this deck and how comfortable you are. I would recommend keeping it in there simply because of the fact that it still struggles a little bit against Face Hunter. I've run against maybe 3 or 4 Face Hunters, and out of the 4 that I played against, I only lost against 1. So in my experience, keeping the Healing Touch in there really does help a lot. It just makes it so that they can't deal with all the taunts that we have in our deck, and ramping it up to the point where they just can't keep up. It's really, really freaking good. The other thing that you could probably take out is Nourish. You could probably get by without this card, but in my experience, this card has actually won me a couple of games keeping it in there. So I would definitely recommend keeping it in there unless you really don't need it. You're definitely going to want to put a second Mulch in there. I didn't have to use it that game. Before the Grand Tournament, Druid struggled really hard with hard removal. Their only removal spell was Naturalize, and it was really terrible because it gave your opponent 2 cards, which is really terrible in the last current meta. So I would definitely put another Mulch in there if you're going to get rid of Healing Touch or if you're going to get rid of the Nourish. But everything else is pretty much needed for this deck. I didn't get to play Emperor Thursday in the last game either. That kind of sucked. But we still won anyways. Like I said, just giant legendaries, guys. It's really hard for your opponents to keep up. If you don't have a lot of the legendaries that you see in this deck, you know, just find their equivalents. If you don't really have the dust to craft the things that you need to craft for this deck, it's really going to suck. But a lot of the stuff you could probably get by with. You could probably get by without Dr. Boom. You could probably get by without Sylvanas. But everything else is basically mandatory. Kel'Thuzad, Rag, Aviana, Cinarius, the cards are just too freaking good. Sludge Belchers, it's a must-have. You need those taunts. Ancient of Wars, a must-have. You need the taunts. If you can Faceless Manipulator, Ancient of Wars, it's so good. I actually had a game where I was able to Faceless Manipulator my Ancient of War twice and play my second Ancient of War on the next turn. Because of Emperor Thursane, it lasted two turns, so it dropped these down to 5 mana, and I played both my Faceless Manipulators, and I had 4 Ancient of Wars on the board, and my opponent was like, I'm done, I'm out of here. So that's it, ladies and gentlemen, thank you all so much for watching, I'll see you guys next time, have a great day.